Welcome to Aussie's group. This is Ritisha again, and I am back with the Grammatical Dreams webinar. We are going to actually go live today, where you might have heard a lot of people saying that you have to be good with grammar, you have to be good with grammatical range. But what is grammatical range? Like, what shows that you are very good with it? So I'll just tell you what grammatical range is and what the examiners expect out of you. Okay, so now if you look at the marking scheme, for a 6, we need to use a mix of simple and complex sentences. For a 7, it states that you have to use a variety of complex sentences. Now, what is a variety of complex sentences meaning here? The variety of complex sentences simply means that you have to indulge yourself in making different types of simple, compound, complex sentences. At the same time, you need to include more than one compound sentence. Now, this is something that you've heard from a lot of people, that add complex sentence. But the question always arises, how? How do we add complex sentences? What is the, you know, basic structure and format of complex sentences? One thing I would want to say is that it is not as complex as it seems. It's very easy. It's just that you need to understand the basic concept, the basic grammatical concept. So firstly, I'll tell you what grammatical range is. See, sentences can be constructed in three different ways in which I would want you to actually construct it. That's simple, compound, complex. Talking about sentence types, what we're going to do today is three different types of sentences. Simple, compound, and complex. If I talk about sentence types, there are 8. Like simple, compound, complex, passive, interrogative, exclamatory, affirmative, negative. So I would want you to focus on these three. Simple, compound, and complex. Whenever you write a paragraph, keep that in mind that at least one or two sentences that you write is a complex sentence. You have to remember this. Okay. Now, second thing, what I want you to understand is the concept of it. How is the simple, compound, and complex sentence formed? So one thing, one terminology I would want to make you aware of, it's called clause. Okay. Now, what is a clause? Clause is simply a sentence or a part of sentence. Understand this? Clause is simply a sentence or a part of sentence. So, it was raining heavily is a sentence. So, I can say it's a clause. Getting it? It was raining heavily is a sentence, and hence I can say it's a clause. Despite the heavy rains, we went home early. Now, this particular sentence is divided into two parts. Despite the heavy rains, we went early. Now, understand the concept of a dependent clause and an independent clause. What is a dependent clause? What was my sentence? Again, let's come back. Despite the heavy rains, we went home early. We went home early is itself complete. It does not require anything else for its completion. And hence, we went home early becomes an independent clause. Whereas, despite the heavy rains, in its own self is not making any sense. Hence, it becomes a dependent clause. Understand? Again, let me go through this with you. What is a clause? A clause is nothing but a sentence or a part of sentence. Right? Okay. There are two types of clauses. Independent clause and a dependent clause. Now, what is an independent clause? A sentence which is complete by its own self is an independent clause. Whereas, a sentence which requires another clause becomes a dependent clause. It's very easy. So, the reason why I'm explaining you this is I'll be using it a lot when I teach you simple, compound, and complex. Hence, I'm trying to explain it to you. Again, I'll repeat the example. Despite the heavy rains, we went home early. We went home early is a sentence which is complete by its own self. Hence, it is an independent clause. Despite the heavy rains. Despite the heavy rains becomes a dependent clause because it needs the former clause. Okay. Now, let's study the first type of sentence. Now, see, generally, simple and compound sentences are something that we use in our day-to-day lives very, subconsciously we tend to use them. We don't even realize that, okay, we are making use of these kind of sentences, but it's very important to know, because make sure that you're not constantly writing simple sentences, neither you're constantly writing compound sentences. Okay, another very important thing that you really have to understand out here is, it's not, it's a myth. Simple sentences are shorter and complex sentences are longer. Not necessary that all long sentences are complex. There are complex sentences which are short as well, and there are simple sentences which are long as well. So the length of the sentence is not determining the type of sentence. Remember this, guys, the length of the sentence is not deciding the type of the sentence. Length of the sentence and type of the sentence are two very different things which are going to be understood today. Okay, now let's go for the simple sentence. Okay, now what is a simple sentence? A simple sentence simply consists one subject, one verb. It expresses a single complete thought. Okay, again I repeat, what is a simple sentence? A simple sentence is nothing but it contains one subject and one verb, and it expresses a single complete thought that can stand on its own. So basically, your independent clause, that one independent clause becomes one simple sentence. Okay, now see, the first sentence says, the baby cried for food. There is one thought. What is the subject here? The baby. What is the verb here? Cried. Okay, food is basically the object here. So basically, simple sentence is nothing but one independent clause. Okay, simple sentence, remember, jot it down in case you have a copy with you. Simple sentence is nothing but one independent clause that expresses one subject, one verb. Okay, it is a complete sentence which can stand on its own. Again, remember, the length of the sentence does not determine whether it's simple, compound or complex. For a simple sentence, the pre-requirement is that it should have one subject, one verb, it should have a one complete thought, it should be an independent clause, right? Now see this. Professor Maple's intelligent students completed and turned in their homework. Now this sentence is comparatively longer. Still, it's simple. Now see, my subject is Professor Maple's intelligent students. Verb is completed and turned. Okay, homework is the object. So again, my requirements of simple sentence, that is your subject, verb, one subject, one verb, also a single thought of expression and an independent clause. All three are sufficed. Okay, now let's do the third example. Megan and Ron ate too much and felt sick. Again here, Megan and Ron are their two subjects, but they mean the same thing. It is still a simple sentence because it is expressing one idea. It is sharing one verb. Okay, so basically, again, one thought, subject, verb, and one independent clause becomes your simple sentence. Remember, simple sentence does not have a conjunction. Remember, when it comes to simple sentence, it's one independent clause, one subject, and one verb. That's it we need to know. Right, coming forward to the compound sentence. Now, what is a compound sentence? Before we do the compound sentence, I want you to know that these are called coordinating conjunctions. What I've written fanboys here are called coordinating conjunctions. For, and, nor, but, or, yet, and so. Fanboys, these are called coordinating conjunctions. Please remember them. The reason is, what is a compound sentence? A compound sentence is filled by one complete thought plus one complete thought connected with the help of fanboy. That is basically two simple sentences joined with the help of fanboy becomes a compound sentence. Compound sentence is nothing but two or more independent clauses that are joined together with the help of fanboys. Now, fanboys is understand this thing, that you have to identify one simple sentence and two simple sentences. In your paragraph, in case you're writing two simple sentences, you simply add a fanboy in it. Fanboy is your coordinating conjunction. and become it becomes a compound sentence automatically. Okay, let's see an example. She completed her homework and she also worked on her project. Now see, here she completed her homework is an independent clause. She went also worked on her project is also an independent clause. I have two independent clauses here. She completed her homework is one independent clause. She also worked on her project is the second independent clause. Both of these are connected with and. And is a part of fanboys and is a coordinating conjunction. So basically one simple sentence plus one simple sentence connected with the help of fanboys becomes a coordinating conjunction. Let's do the second one. I got the map of the fair, but I cannot find the food stall. Now again, let's see. I got the map of the fair. Complete sentence. Yes. I cannot find the food stall. Even that's a complete sentence. Now, both of these complete sentences joined with the help of fanboys, connected with the help of a fanboy, but gives me a compound sentence. Now see this. We can film a documentary or we can make a short film. Again, check the same logic. We can film a documentary is a compound is a simple sentence because it expresses one idea, one verb, one subject. We can make a short film is also a simple sentence because it's an independent clause. So now again, two independent clauses or two simple sentences joined with the help of or becomes your compound sentence. Okay, let's do the next one. The novel is huge, so you must make time to read. This novel is huge, so you must make time to read. So this novel is huge becomes a complete sentence. This novel is my subject, is my verb. Okay. You must make time to read. You is the subject, must make becomes the verb, time to read. Okay. So now I have two simple sentences connected with the help of fanboys becomes a compound sentence. Okay, let's revise a little bit up till now. Two types of sentence I've covered. One is a simple, one is a compound. What is a simple sentence? A simple sentence is nothing but an independent clause, which expresses a single thought, which expresses one subject and one verb. What is a compound sentence? A compound sentence is nothing but a combination of two independent clauses, that is two simple sentences connected with the help of fanboys, for and nor, but, or yet and so. Okay, let's go to complex sentences. Now see, when it comes to simple and compound sentence, it's something that we actually when it comes to compound sentences, it's something that we actually do it by ourselves very easily. Like simple and compound sentences are easier to write and hence subconsciously, even though not paying much thought to it, we end up writing it. So it's not something that really makes a lot of sense. However, it is the complex sentences that need to be consciously written, that need to be consciously understood how to write. And hence, the whole ordeal of understanding what a dependent clause is and what an independent clause is important. Now, till the time simple and compound sentences are involved, only independent clauses are involved. Only the sentences which make sense by itself are involved. In simple sentence, it's going to be a subject, it's going to be a verb, and it's going to be one independent clause. In a compound sentence, there's going to be two independent clauses connected with the help of fanboys. However, now here, with the complex sentence, the dependent clause comes into action. So, if you remember, to make a compound sentence, I needed coordinating conjunctions. Which are the coordinating conjunctions again? Fanboy. To make a complex sentence, I will need subordinating conjunctions. Here is a list of subordinating conjunctions that I have. So basically, subordinating conjunctions are nothing but though, although, despite, during, which, when, where, despite, in spite, whereby, all these become your subordinating conjunctions. Now, basically, in the subordinating conjunction, what you have to do in the complex sentences, connect one dependent clause plus one independent clause. Let me show you a few samples. Let me show you how to do it. Okay, Now, basically, complex sentence is nothing but an independent clause joined by one or more dependent clause. Okay. Now, understand one thing, that it always has a subordinator as, because, since, although, after. Now, see this. I have an example which I have done. After eating lunch at the Cheesecake Factory, Tim went to the gym to exercise. Now, here, see. Tim went to the gym to exercise is a complete sentence. It is a sentence which is complete by its own. So, this becomes an independent clause. Now, look at the first half of the sentence. After eating lunch at the Cheesecake Factory. Now, is after eating lunch at the Cheesecake Factory making any sense by its own? No, right? So, this becomes a dependent clause. So, my first half of the sentence is dependent on the second half. So, my first half of the sentence is a dependent clause. The second half of the sentence is an independent clause which is joined by the subordinative word after. Hence, this becomes a complex sentence. Again, see this. After eating lunch at the Cheesecake Factory, Tim went to the gym to exercise. So, Tim went to the gym to exercise becomes a complete clause, a independent clause. After eating lunch at the Cheesecake Factory becomes a dependent clause. Hence, a combination of dependent clause and an independent clause becomes your complex sentence. Okay, now I have done few more examples of complex sentences. Although the breeze was steady, both kites continued to dive. Now see, both kites continued to dive is a complete sentence. Although the breeze was steady is making no sense by its own. So now a complete clause and an incomplete clause becomes your complex sentence. Despite the fact that your parrot talks, it cannot sing. It cannot sing expresses one idea, one verb, and it's complete on its own. Despite the fact that your parrot talks, so that is incomplete. So a complete and an incomplete sentence becomes your complex sentence. On the lookout of hungry birds, the crab scuttled across the sand. So again, the crab scuttled across the sand is one idea. On the lookout of hungry birds is another idea. So on the lookout of hungry birds is a dependent clause which needs the former, the latter clause, that is the crab scuttled across the sand. Okay, when we buy her the birthday cake, we have to make sure it's strawberry. We have to make sure it's strawberry is an independent clause, whereas when we buy her the birthday cake is a dependent clause, which makes this a complex sentence. Now, let's see. Although some winemakers carry out fermenting process by using yeast that is naturally present in the grapes, many add a yeast that is cultivated in a laboratory. Now this becomes your complex sentences. Again, the first half is incomplete, the second half is complete. Okay, now if you go to see, we have all types of sentences in which the dependent clause is first and then comes the independent clause. The sentence can have a reverse scenario as well. Whereas a dependent clause can be later, the dependent clause can also be, in the middle of the sentence. So, we'll see an example of that. Okay, what I really want you to understand is to make a complex sentence, you will need to know what subordinating conjunction are. So, before that, there is one last type of sentence that I want to show you. That's called the compound complex. Now, basically, what is a compound sentence? A compound sentence is basically one independent clause plus one independent clause connected with the help of fanboys. What is a complex sentence? One independent clause, one dependent clause connected with the help of subordinate conjunction. So that's what a complex and a compound sentence is. Now, compound complex is nothing but when you mix both of them. There is one compound sentence, that is means there are two independent clauses plus a dependent clause. Okay. That makes it a compound complex sentence. Again, I repeat, what is a compound sentence? Compound sentence is nothing but one independent clause plus one independent clause connected with the help of fanboys. What is a complex sentence? One independent clause plus one dependent clause connected with the help of a subordinating clause. Now, what is this compound complex sentence? A compound complex sentence is nothing but when you join these two together, when you connect these two together, so that becomes a compound complex sentence. You can have a look at the example. Okay, after the two soccer players lost the game, they joined the other teammates for lunch and they went for the movies. So after the two soccer players lost their game is a dependent clause. Okay, they joined their teammates for lunch and they went for the movies. So they joined their teammates for lunch and they went to the movies is a compound sentence. One, two independent clauses connected with the help of fanboys. Okay, now the first half of it, that is after the soccer players lost their game, so that becomes a complex sentence. The reason is that's a dependent clause. So whenever a dependent clause comes into action, it's a complex sentence. Okay, the man believed in the system and he knew that justice would prevail after the murderer was sent to jail. Now see, again, understand this fact that there are two complex sentences here. In this particular example, there are two complex sentences, there are two compound sentences and one complex sentence. Two independent clause plus one dependent clause, yet the brevity of the sentence is maintained, yet the length is comparatively shorter. It's not very long. See this. The man believed in the system. Full stop. Can I make this a complete sentence? So this becomes an independent clause. And he knew justice would prevail. Again, this is a full stop. This is an independent clause. After the murderer was sent to jail. So this becomes a dependent clause. So one independent clause plus one independent clause gives me a plus one dependent clause gives me a compound complex sentence. Now see, coming to the band descriptor table, if you go to see, for above a 7, you need to demonstrate your ability to have grammatical range, okay? Grammatical range in which all my, write-up is not monotonous. If I don't want my write-up to be monotonous, how should my write-up be? It should have a lot of sentences. I cannot say this is this, right? I cannot do that. So here, in this particular write-up, what is there is, whenever you write an essay, okay, you're doing one paragraph. Check that paragraph. How many simple sentences are there? How many compound sentences are there? Have you included a complex sentence? So if you've not included a complex sentence, you have to include a complex sentence. So basically, it is these minor things that actually make a difference. Now see, I'll just get you through this again. To understand simple, compound, complex is very simple. All you have to do is understand the basic rules of it. The first thing that you really need to understand is what are conjunctions. Let me explain you what are conjunctions again. Conjunction is nothing but when you join one word with another, with a set of words, that becomes a conjunction. There are two types of conjunctions that we need to know: coordinating and subordinating. Now, what is a coordinating conjunction? A coordinating conjunction is a conjunction which is fanboys. Simple as that. FANBOYS. These seven conjunctions are your coordinating conjunctions. These seven conjunctions are something for a compound sentence. That is for, and, nor, but, or, yet, and so. Okay. Then, these are called coordinating conjunctions. What is the other type of conjunction? It's called subordinating conjunction. Now, what is a subordinating conjunction? Because, though, although, in spite, where, whereby, despite, besides, any after, before, during, which, while, when, where. Basically, any word that connects two sentences, which connects a subordinate clause, becomes a subordinative conjunction. So, again, two types of conjunction, coordinating and subordinating. There are two types of clause now. Again, for this, the simple, compound, complex, we need to understand conjunction and we need to understand clause. So, one is there are two types of conjunction. Now, there are two types of clause. Which two types of clause are there? Dependent and independent. What is a dependent clause? Dependent clause is a clause which needs other clause for its completion. Independent clause is basically one subject, one verb, expresses a single idea. Coming to the simple sentence, it is one independent clause, no conjunction. Coming to the compound sentence, it is one independent clause plus one more independent clause connected with the help of fanboys. One independent clause plus another independent clause connected with the help of fanboys gives you your compound sentence. Complex sentence is basically dependent. Now that's where dependent clause comes into action. One dependent clause plus one independent clause connected with the help of subordinate conjunction. after while, which, because, that's called for compound sentence. Now, compound complex. This is something that try using in your writing to get a good impact. Now, what is a compound complex? Independent plus dependent. Again, simple, independent, one independent. Compound, one independent plus one independent. Complex, one independent plus one dependent. Compound complex, one independent plus one independent plus one dependent. So this is a basic layout of this. Now I've prepared one sample on how you're supposed to write. Let's check that out. Okay, now let's say I'm writing an essay on global warming. This is how you write your essay on global warming. So global warming is a less common topic these days. Global warming causes environmental problems. There are tough challenges associated with global warming, and global warming has very serious consequences. I've made two complex sentences here, which is what you have to demonstrate for a 7. This is what they're expecting for a 7, a higher order of language. That higher order of language is something that you will get only when you know the concept of compound sentence. Now see this. One of the most common environmental issues is global warming, which causes many serious environmental problems. Here, this is a complex sentence because one of the most common environmental issues is global warming. Full stop becomes my complete sentence, and that's a simple sentence. Causes many social environmental problems. Now this is dependent, so independent plus dependent becomes your complex. Okay, the next sentence. There are tough challenges associated with the issue, and its effects has various serious consequences. Tough challenges associated with this issue and effects have serious consequences. Again, this is a complex sentence. So, how do you actually inculcate the habit of writing complex sentences? So, what I normally advise my students is write an essay, write one paragraph. Review that one paragraph only. You're writing that one paragraph, so you know, just check, have you included a complex sentence? Have you included a compound complex sentence? If you have not, erase it and make sure you do. Now that you know that making complex sentences is very easy, it's just hyped up, just understand the basic concept. I can get you to the theory of clauses, independent. I don't want you to get into the theory of it. Your only job is to understand what these three types of sentences are and utilize them and use them. This is all what we have to do, and this is all what we will do. Understand this. Again, when you write body paragraph, one, check whether you've written two complex sentences or whether you've written two simple sentences. Is a compound sentence possible? Is a complex sentence possible out of it? If it's possible, make. Okay, now a very important point here is focus on grammatical accuracy as well. Make sure you're not neglecting grammatical accuracy when it comes to making simple, compound, complex. A lot of students have this habit of making long sentences. All the sentences are, you know, grammatically incorrect. Rather, I should say that make shorter ones and be grammatically accurate. Because, you know, making no errors in grammar is also equally important. So, this is something that I would want to tell you. This is a slightly difficult topic to understand, guys. And I have explained it in a very simple way. What I want you to do is when you study this, make sure that you have a notebook in your hand and you keep jotting down the points, because the way I've explained is very, very basic, very, very simple, and this is all what you have to know. I've covered an extensive, it's like a proper comprehensive, you know, subject teaching that I've done when it comes to simple, compound, complex. This is all what is needed. This is all what you have to do. You don't have to do anything else compared to this. Okay, we have a Telegram group. It's called IELTS Tutorials. You can come join us there. We'll be there, happy to help you. There are other members, there are students, those of you who are a part of the group and are here. Thank you for joining me live this morning. You can join us. We have ielts.online. That's our web portal. We're offering all types of services in case you want online coaching, in case paper checking, everything. I mean, we're always happy to help you. And there are different tests on them. You know, there are a lot of mock tests. You can try them. First of all, I would say that grammatical range and grammatical accuracy is a subject that is very important when it comes to your, writing and speaking. Basically, it holds 20% of weightage when it comes to writing and speaking. So please work on it. Do not ignore it. I've given you the basic rules for simple, compound, complex. First, understand the base. First, understand conjunctions. Then, understand clauses. understand there are two types of conjunctions, understand there are two types of clauses, and it's because of these conjunctions and clauses, the simple, compound and complex sentence alter. The simple and compound sentence only have independent clauses, they don't have a dependent clause. Simple has one, independent has two, again connected with the help of and voice. The complex sentence is where the dependent clause come into action. So complex sentence is one independent plus one dependent. Compound complex is nothing but two independent and one dependent. So it's a very, very simple logic. You'll be able to do it very well. And keep writing complex sentences and post it in the Telegram group. Let me review it for you. Let me check whether you're writing it properly or no. And thank you guys for being with me this morning. I hope this concept was clear to you. Please, please pay attention to this. This holds 25% of the weightage. However accurate in grammar you are, if you don't write a mix of sentences, you're not going to get above 6. So please make sure that you write a mix of sentences. Please make sure that you have a variety of sentences, else it doesn't, you know, make a difference. I shall see you guys next Saturday again with this different topics every time. If you have any doubts in this, please post it in the comment box. I'd be happy to help you. I'd be happy to answer you. Any other doubts, you can post it in the Telegram group. We're there for you guys. And make complex sentences and score very good in your writing, guys. Thank you so much and have a very, very happy weekend ahead.